Hi guys, I am Mutyekwa L. Mdangeni with MathsXYZ, and in this lesson, which is lesson 87, I will be taking you through the examples of applying the sine rule in trigonometry. So I will take you through all the trigonometry that you need to know so that you will be able to answer all the questions concerning the sine rule when you are calculating the area of a triangle. So the sine rule, in most cases, you apply it when you are dealing with a non-right angle triangle where you won't be able to use the theorem of Pythagoras. Then in this case, you remember the sine rule that I've done in the previous lesson, which was lesson 84, and I explained that the sine rule, the equation of the sine rule is A divided by the sine of A, which the sine of A, the small a is the opposite side of the angle of A. It's equals to B divided by the sine of B, of which this is angle B, it's opposite to the side of B. Then this one, it will be C divided by the sine of angle C, of which they are opposite to each other. Then let's go straight to the question where we are asked to find the value of X in the triangle ABC, of which the angle of A is equal to 62 degrees, as you can see there, and the angle of B is unknown, and the angle of C is equal to 46 degrees. And the side of AB is X, and the side of BC is equal to 8 meters. Then we are asked to find the unknown, which is X length of between A and B. Alright, so with the sine rule, what you need to understand is that the sine of A, which is this one, it must be divided by the opposite side, of which it's equal to 8 meters in this case. So the sine of C, which is this one, it will be divided by the opposite side, which is equal to X meters right there, which is what we are supposed to find. Then what we need to do here is that we have to first write the equation. So I always prefer it that if you were to find the side, then you must have the side in the denominator. And if you are about to find the angle, then have the angle in the denominator. I mean in the numerator. All right, then here I made a mistake because it was going to be in the denominator. Then in the numerator, we're going to have X, because that is what we are looking for. And then that will be divided by the sine of C, which is the angle of C. Alright, this will be equals to 8, I won't write 8 meters first, I will write the equation. Then this will be equals to the sine of BC divided by the sine of A, angle of A. Then from here, we'll be able to just punch everything into the equation, and then we'll have our answer. Then if you don't want to write the values in the first step, what you can do is you can have X as the subject to the formula, and then after that, you will be able to just punch in the values, and that will be your answer. Of which, this is what I'm going to do right here. It will be X is equals to BC. So this will cross multiply with that, and will be the sine of C. Angle of C divided by the sine of A, angle of A. Then from here, I'll just write the values now, which is 8 meters, sine of C, which is 46 degrees, divided by the sine of A, which is sine of 62 degrees. And then here, I'm going to have my answer. I'll just write, punch everything in my calculator and see what I'm going to get. So it will be 8, the sine of 46, sine of 46 degrees divided by the sine of 62 degrees, of which from there I got 6.52 meters. So this will be 6.52 meters. That is the value of X in this in triangle ABC. Alright, I hope you guys understood this example here, of which it's more similar to the next example that we're going to do, of which we are given triangle PQR. I will erase the equation right here because I believe you guys already have it from the previous lessons that we did. So in triangle PQR, of which PQ, the side of PQ is equal to 23 meters, and the side of QR is equal to 43 meters, and we are asked to find the value of P, which is X, of is unknown, and we also given the value of R, which is 8 degrees. So what we are trying to find in this example is the angle, of which, remember I told you guys that whatever you're trying to find, is better to have it in the numerator and instead of being in the denominator. Then we're going to have the sine of P, which is what we're looking for, which is the X, divided by the side of QR, It's equals to, so whatever you have, if it's a side of Q, it must be divided by its opposite side. Like this one, the opposite side to this is equals to, it's 43 meters there. And the opposite side to angle of R, it's the 23 meters there. Then here we're gonna have the sine of R, angle of R divided by the side of QP. All right, then now that we're looking for that, we'll just punch everything in. It will be the sine of P, which will be equals to the QR, it's actually equals to 43 meters, multiplied by the sine of R, which is 8 degrees, divide by the sine, oh sorry, not the sine, divide by the side of QP, which is equals to 23 meters. So this will be equals to 23 meters. Then what are we gonna get? I'll just punch everything back into the calculator. So we're gonna have 43 sine of 8 degrees divided by 23 meters. Then we're gonna have 0.26, and then to find the angle of P, it will be sine function, and I got P as equals to P, angle of P is equals to 15.08 degrees. All right. Then with this type of question, mostly they are the ambiguous question that all the time that the angle that we are trying to find, it has two answers. So in this case, as you can see that Q actually, P, the angle of P there, it actually looks bigger than the angle of Q, if you can just see from the diagram, that this angle is the it's bigger than these two angles right there. So what we need to find to get the second question, what you do is to say 180 minus the answer that you found when you were using the sine rule. So here we're going to have 180 degrees minus 15.08 degrees. Then here we're going to find 180 minus that. So I'll just say 180 minus ans, which I got 164.92 degrees. All right, now it makes sense that P being, if you can just see from this triangle, that the angle of P is actually bigger than these two angles here. So if it's 164, it makes sense because this angle, as you can see from the triangle, that is, it actually does look greater than 90 degrees. All right, then it's called an ambiguous question where you will have your answers, two answers, when you are trying to find the angle. All right, guys, let's just do one more example, which is the last one for this lesson. So this example here, we are given triangle PQR. PQR with the angle of P being 24 degrees, the angle of R being 86 degrees, and the side of PR, which is what we're trying to find, it's X, and also the side of QR, which is given as 12 meters. So we are asked to find the value of X, which is the unknown length between P and R. Then with this one, remember when you are applying the sine rule, it should be sine of the angle divided by the side, the opposite side of which, the sine of 86, it should be divided by the side of PQ. And the sine of 24, which is opposite to 12 meters, and the sine of Q, it's opposite to X. So with this case, if we are, for example, we have a lot of unknowns in this question here. So it will be the sine of P, of which P is there. Remember, guys, I told you that whatever I'm trying to find, it should be in the numerator. So let me start with that. So it will be X divided by the sine of Q. So in this case, both the X is unknown and also Q is unknown. So it will be a bit difficult that we have to find one of the two, so that we'll only remain with one unknown. Then this will be equals to the sine. Oh, sorry, I have to start. If you start with the length on that side, also after the equal sign, you must start with the length, not with the side, with the angle. Then here we're gonna have the side, which is QR, divided by the sine of P, angle of P. Then from here we have the two unknown, which is X, that's what we're trying to find, and also we don't have the angle of Q. Then we have to find one of the two so that we'll be able to find the answer. But then let's look at the angle of Q. How do we find the angle of Q? the angle of Q to find it, it will be quite easy because the angles of a triangle is equals to 180, remember? Then that will be 180 minus these two angles. It will actually give us the angle of Q right there. So I'll just write it there. So let's say our X, to find our X, it will be X is equals to QR, of which we do have the value of QR, it's equals to 12 meters, the sine of Q divided by the sine of P. Alright, then from here, we just have to punch in everything and write in the value so that we'll be able to find the value of X. Then continuing going this side, it will be X is equals to the value of QR. We already know what's the value of QR. It's equals to 12 meters. Then I will have my 12 meters there multiplied by the sine of Q, of which, remember, the sine of Q, it is the Q which is unknown, but we already know how to find it. It will be 180 minus these two angles which are, we already have the values of. Then it will be 180 degrees minus 86 degrees minus 24 degrees. All right, then we have that. So that will be divided by the sine of P, which we already know it's equals to 24 degrees. Then it will be 24 degrees there. Then here we're gonna have we are done with the question. We just have to punch everything into the calculator so that we'll be able to find the value of X. So it will be 12 multiplied by the sine of 180 minus 86 minus 24 divided by sine of 24 degrees. Oh, sorry, let me just check. Oh yeah, it is 24 degrees. Then here the answer, we got 27.72 meters. So the answer for the value of X, it will be 27.72 meters. So that will be the value of X. Remember guys, to always write your SI unit so that you won't be penalized for not writing the SI unit. So here we're gonna have X as 27.72 meters. All right guys, this was actually one of the question where you have to apply two things so that you'll be able to find the answer. The first thing that you have to apply is the sine rule, and then after that you will notice that you have two unknowns. So with one equation you won't be able to solve for the either unknown if you have two unknown in one equation. Then what you do is to find the value of Q using the sum of triangle is equals to 180, of which this is what we did right here. Alright, and then after that you will be able to find your unknown value of X, which is 27.72 meters. Alright guys, I hope you understood everything when concerning the sine rule when trying to find the angle or the value of the unknown length in the triangle. Remember, you can only apply the sine rule when you are trying to find the unknown angle in the triangle and also the unknown length in the triangle. I hope you understood everything in this lesson, and if you didn't guys, you know the drill. You just have to drop us a comment and we'll have a follow-up on it. Please don't forget to subscribe to Maths XYZ channel on YouTube so that you'll be able to get notification when we upload videos. Thank you.